I grew up in Lawrence County, Kentucky, you know, songwriting, telling stories. It's a trait of people from my area. I like to tell tales and sat around a lot with my dad around hunting clubs and outside of church and barbershops, listening to fellas older than me tell tall tales and flat out lies. And I guess some of that rubbed off on me.
Let's try Lady Meg one.
All right.
What kind of intro we got? Ready when you are, baby.
I don't see songwriting as a job so much as it's something to do to keep from working. I wrote a lot while I was working. Like, I used to work for this company and spent a lot of time denailing. It's pretty zen once you get into it. All you're doing is just taking nails out of old wood.
When my working day is over, we'll go swim our cares away.
When I would get in the swing of things, I'd just start humming melodies to myself and hearing lines and be like, oh, that would go good with this melody, you know, and then just it was kind of a way to pass the time.
Now I ain't the sharpest chisel that your hands have ever held, but darling, I could love you well till the roll.
I think it was a rumble queen.
That's what it was, like a.
Yeah, there's a rumble back there. Might be on one of the guitar mics. You might have thumped one.
See? So it's my fault now.
It's his fault.
Always.
Wish Sturgill was here to blame it on us.
Yeah.
Well, that was pretty good, though.
Yeah. Let's do it one more time, and then if it don't happen, then it ain't going to happen any better.
Lord, the wind can leave you shivering as the waltzes or leaves.
First and foremost, I'm writing for myself, for my own sanity. From there, you know, I write a lot of love songs for Sonora.
Now the mountains all are blushing, cause he don't know what to say, except a good long line of praises for my lovely Lady May.
My wife's name's Sonora May. Sonora May Childers. It used to be any time that I'd get in trouble or upset her, it was just as easy as writing her a love song, you know? And then nowadays, it's not nearly as effective as it used to be. Nowadays, I usually have to do something else on top of that.
Through the forest as you cut my roots away, and I fell a good long ways for my lovely lady.
Thank Ty.
Yeah.
That one felt real nice, man.
Yeah, I like that one better.
That was
better.
Lonesome, dude.
I'm going to sit here and I'm going to be like, no, you do this.
No,
if you can take this.
No, go down there and then we'll, you know.
Tyler.
Yeah.
You do your job, I'll do mine.
There you go.
I don't know. This one right here?
Tell me that you love. It's kind of a producer's dream. You don't have to do much guiding. And he's a really nice kid. And he's born with a great voice. Every once in a while, you run across one that has it. And this guy, he's got what it takes, man.
Love you well.
Are we good with that, Sean?
Good.
Got a good clean ending on it?
Good clean, fade.
Good front.
Ready for the next.
What you gonna do next, buddy?
Figure we'll do Creaker.
Hey, Tyler. On the intro, maybe on the intro, you just go, just start with the minor. Do-do-do-do-do-do.
I wrote Creaker in Chicago. We were partying and playing music till like 6 o'clock in the morning, and woke up at like 5 o'clock in the day, and got an Uber into town to catch my cousin. The Uber dropped me off a long ways away from where I was supposed to be.
Further.
So I ran into this fella and I was like, hey man, I'm lost. I'm supposed to be at this address. And he was like, man, you're like a 30-minute car ride. I was like, well, I'm a little farther than what I want to walk today. I had like 2% left on my phone and I had $5. And so I just found the nearest bar and told him that I'd have whatever $5 could get me. And I really need to charge his phone.
Drink and love as he looks out the window.
So I sat there and drank what they gave me and let my phone charge up and got hold of my cousin and told him that I was lost. I needed him to come get me. So, yeah, I just wrote Creaker there in that moment.
In a small corn bar sits there drinking, lost as a ball in a field full of corn. Further away than he ever imagined that he'd ever end up from the place he was born. Now no more forlorn whiskey, the one that you see outside of your eye, drinking alone as he looks out the window at all of the strangers on the corner outside. And he'd rather be dead than alive one more.
Say